At some point in their early history, every game studio was an indie. But as the gaming industry grew to the point that it was an industry being steered by huge mega companies, it became necessary to distinguish between the two. The first recognized indie game is Cave Story, but the first notable indie character is one that so many smashers have been asking for.
Oh, please.
Wow.
No!
What's that?
Polo?
You know, between Shantae and the last two movesets I did for Lara and Alex, they can make like a fighter pass of total freaking babes, man. Nintendo planted the seeds of a partnership with the indie community in the Wii U 3DS era that blossomed on the Switch. And it's been reflected in Smash with a Shovel Knight assist trophy and very convincing Mii costumes for Sans and Cuphead. However, if there is one indie character I've seen more vocal support for than any other except maybe Minecraft Steve, it's Shantae. And there are so many reasons to invite her to Smash that it just fucks with my head that they haven't. She's highly requested. She has a history with Nintendo dating back to her debut on the Game Boy Color. She's the OG indie darling. She has a cartoony style that meshes perfectly with most other franchises. It probably wouldn't be as expensive to license as others. WayForward even encouraged fans to vote for her in the Smash ballot. But most of all, she has the potential to be one of the coolest, funnest, thickest, most interesting fighters in the whole damn game.
G!
Half Genie Hero.
Shantae is a half-genie, half-human dancer that guards the small fishing village of Scuttletown, most often from the nefarious but equally lady pirate, Risky Boots. She possesses several magical abilities such as her signature ponytail whip and transforming into animals just by dancing, as well as a bunch of items, spells, and pirate gear. She's very brave, but very naive, very strong, but very silly, very animated, but still very...
Hamina.
Speaking of which, the first thing to discuss is her appearance. Of the five games, each have featured slightly different art styles. Smash would obviously create a 3D model of this so far only 2D character, but if they had to pick one to draw influence from, I would prefer the one from Pirate's Curse in a heartbeat. The edges are sharper instead of rounded, the facial features are better, and let's be real, this entry's got the best boob design.
I thought so.
Meanwhile, her ults make good use of all the costumes she's rocked over the years. First off is the dancer outfit from Risky's Revenge, which is identical to the space pirate outfit from Pirate's Curse, which is just... Also from Pirate's Curse are her swashbuckling accessories. Then from Half Genie Hero, there's her ninja, cop, beach, and jammy outfits. And last, but certainly not least, Bikini Shantae! Shantae has so much potential for Smash that I was conflicted between lots of different options for everything down to her entrance. At first, I wanted her to enter the stage by flying in on a magic carpet.
Just like a genie!
And I nearly went with that because she never really had a proper entrance in the games. Until Half Genie Hero. She travels the world map with Sky and Wrench and gets dropped off in each level. I was gonna go with this because I like movesets that stay loyal to the source material, but I have something else planned for Sky and the other characters, so fuck it, I'm going with the magic carpet idea.
Like it.
Can't believe it, I'm losing to a rug.
Being a dancer, Shantae can never seem to stand still, and her fighting stance is the same infectious dance she's always done. As an added treat, She shakes her hips to the beat of whatever music is playing during the match. Over 100% damage, however, her groove gets a little weak. And for her idol animation, she adjusts her ponytail. And her duck is that same little squinty-eyed butt shake she's always done. Anyone who's played a Shantae game knows that her neutral standard is her signature hair whip. Instead of a 1-2-3 jab, this is a single attack that can be spammed. The move's power and speed is fully upgraded with all the shampoo and silky cream in a single entry. I just have to ask, how does she not break her neck doing that all the time? Her side tilt is the heavy kick from Pirate's Curse.
Ha!
Now, the original game had a set of fighting gear that she could purchase, and her up tilt uses the boot, where she performed a long-range uppercut. Her down tilt uses the sash, where she'll jump a short distance and drill down at an angle. And lastly, her dash attack is done with the cuffs, where she lunges forward with her elbow pointed out. Shantae has a very distinct jump where she leaps up, arms out, and bends her knees at the apex, then straightens out as she lands. Something about it is just really genie-like. I don't know. Maybe it's those MC Hammer pants. Obviously, this has to be perfectly replicated for her single jump, and her double jump gives her an extra boost with a shot from Risky's cannon. It was technically loaded with 3 extra jumps in the game, but in the name of balancing, let's not get carried away here. Literally. Her neutral aerial attack materializes 3 pike balls to revolve around her before vanishing. The move can be repeated with little start and end lags, but it can also be penetrated with good timing. Her forward air is another hair whip with slightly less power and speed than her jab. I won't give the explanation of a sex kick since I did it in Lara's video, so here's the wiki page and here's Shantae's back aerial.
Ha!
Her up aerial makes use of the last piece of original fighting gear, the tiara, where she does a multi-hit tornado-like spin. It moved her side to side in the game, but here it just sends her straight up. And her down air is none other than the scimitar, a downward aerial attack if there ever was one. Alright, her grab moves were the only ones I had to make originals for, but I actually really love how they turned out. She grabs an opponent with both hands and then treats them like a dance partner. For the pummel, she steps on their toes. This is normally one of the crappiest mistakes you can make when dancing, but she's a pro who turns it into a tactic.
Oh, yeah.
For her forward throw, she spins her partner around and bounces them away with her hip, or maybe her belly since she is a belly dancer. For her back throw, she twirls them around midair and releases. This is basically an echo of Mario's back throw, but more dancey. For her down throw, she does a dip move but drops them to the floor. And her up throw is some sort of upward dance move, I don't know.
You can't be serious.
We're gonna dance our asses off!
Her shield is actually her bubble shield, which is not unlike a pink Smash shield, but just blue. Her shield roll is the back dash, a stylish move featured in most games that I believe is best animated in Pirate's Curse, because she does that little twirl. But the backdash from Half Genie Hero would make a good animation for the aerial dodge. You know when you get hit in Smash and you can recover mid-air? Well, Shantae does that exact thing with her recover move from Pirate's Curse. Shantae's Smash attacks finally put her second biggest features to use, the animal transformations. In the games, she performs specific dance moves to achieve these forms, and in Smash, she dances as the smash attack is being charged. Then she transforms to execute the attack before quickly changing back.
That is awesome!
Her side smash is the monkey claw, her down smash is the elephant stomp, and her up smash is the spider venom. This one might require more explaining than the other two. She shoots out a web line that can stretch a couple meters, and if anyone is struck by it, she quickly reels them in for a poisonous bite. Her neutral special is the flintlock pistol, fully powered and ready to go. It was going to be the Spitfire, but I just love the pirate stuff. Besides, she only whips out the pistol if you tap the B button, hold it, and she'll unleash her true firepower, the flamethrower. Her side special is Risky's boots. In the game, she had to charge the move by running about a screen's length, so technically it is a charge move, and I almost made this the dash before realizing the cuffs made more sense for that move. So here she just charges in place and lets loose upon release. If charged all the way, she'll run indefinitely until hitting a wall for a bit of end lag or canceling out. Another chargeable attack that the side special could be are the puff clouds, but I didn't want another projectile move on top of the neutral special. Her down special is a basic counter move which she does with the mirror from Half Genie Hero. And lastly, for her up special, she transforms into the harpy. She does it immediately without dancing, which is why I hesitated on doing this, but I wanted to include all of her original animal forms, and it just makes the most sense for a recovery. So I'm gonna justify it by how in Half Genie Hero, the transformation mechanic is basically instant. She flaps up at a slightly higher distance than her two jumps, and while the move itself doesn't cause any damage, you can press the A button to attack with the Harpy Tower, which can be used as much as 3 times before going into freefall. And finally, her final smash. I actually had a lot of trouble with this. There's no particular item or transformation or anything in the series that seemed like Final Smash material to me. So my idea was she does a belly dance and transforms into the Sophia 3, a weird tank form that moves super fast and shoots out these green balls of energy.
Energy ball? Ever seen my partner here?
Looks like a shit ball.
We're not done yet. Shantae still has a few numbers in her repertoire. Her up taunt is dancing with the magic lamp like when sucking up clouds of dark magic. Her side taunt is pointing in the direction she's facing and saying,
Reptune go!
And her down taunt is an awesome little reference to another super hot genie. Her victory animations include spinning around in the air like when completing a dungeon, her pose when completing a level in Half Genie Hero, and the third one is just dancing. Shantae's stage is nothing else than her humble home of Scuttletown. The fighters duke it out in the foreground while the town plays out in the background, and this is where all the other lovable characters make their appearance. Her uncle Mimic occasionally pokes his head out of the window of his workshop, Bolo bumbles around and runs away when he notices the fighting, Sky flies by with Wrench, Squid Baron's just hanging around, and at some point, Risky Boots shows up in her ship and creates a stage hazard by unloading cannonballs on the fighters. At the same time, in the background, a crew of Tinkerbats raise the town up in flames until being washed away by heavy rains and winds, at which point the stage resets. Oh, and Roddy Tops.
Roddy Tops.
Roddy Tops.
I'm sorry, is anyone else hearing if loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right, very, very quietly?
And that brings me to the last detail. The music. Dear sweet genie Jesus, the music. You know, one of the best parts of Smash Brothers is getting to hear fully orchestrated live recorded renditions of video game music. But I don't even want them to touch this one, man. Just upload the whole damn Pirate's Curse soundtrack and call it a day. Every song on that record is a fucking banger. With spirits for both her and Risky Boots, Shantae is highly unlikely at this point. Is what I had written in the script before Min Min got in. Hope has been restored, faith revived, and horizons expanded. But even if she doesn't make it into Ultimate, I do foresee her making the cut for some entry at some point. Until then, I can only dream of Genie. So if you're also dreaming about Shantae every single night, smash that like button, leave a comment, sub to the channel, and maybe one day, Sakurai will grant our wish.
Like a genie!
Ha 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 ha!